If you're emotionally eating right now or stressful eating and trying to figure out a solution, hopefully my story is going to impact you just enough to hopefully quit and just say, wow, there is a solution. My name is Jason Rosell. I am a lifestyle and wellness coach on television and online. For several years, I was very overweight. I was depressed, bullied, and unhappy. And let me tell you, I was always emotionally and stressful eating. And it was a very unhappy period of my life for 20 years. I found myself being 75 pounds overweight, reaching 225 pounds, a size 40 waist, stretch marks up to my stomach, arms, my butt, my legs, all over. Let's just say I was not comfortable ever being naked. And I can say that because being fat sucks, along with being depressed, being unhappy. Point is, when you're not happy and you're stressed, like a lot of you watching right now, and maybe you particularly right now saying, well, damn, I'm not happy in a lot of things and I'm overeating. Hopefully I'm gonna give you the solution as to how to replace food for comfort and find other things that you're gonna love and thrive on to help you in your mind and body. Now, a lot of people always wanna know my full backstory. I'm not gonna get into that today. You can see that on my website, jasonrosell.com. The link is on the description. Most importantly, no matter what you're going through in life, right? The first tip I guess I wanna tell you is no one's perfect. You're not perfect, I'm not perfect, no one's perfect. So we tend to be, unfortunately, perfectionist. We want to play the blaming game. Oh my God, well, I should be looking like this, or we compare ourselves to others. We start creating our own stress psychologically in our heads, and what happens? One of the triggers is we wanna go and eat. Comfort food, emotionally eat. We're creating stress and having stressful eating. Now, no matter if it's in your relationships with your coworkers, whether it's with your wife, your husband, your kids are driving you up a wall, the kitty cat, the dog walking by, whatever it is, the guy cutting you off. All these things are triggers that are causing stress and making that and causing you to just simply eat and overeat for no reason. It's kind of like someone that's having a bad day smoking a cigarette and he's saying, well, that's not enough and I want more and more and more, right? We become victims of overindulging. And unfortunately with food, which was my best friend and a lot of millions of people in the world's best friend, causes you to gain weight and become very unhealthy. Now, how I personally changed, transformed, and a lot of my clients was by simply accepting the fact that you're stressed out, whatever's causing it, and instead of reacting by simply going to get food, just acknowledging it and doing an activity in that moment that will replace the feeling of hunger and saying, oh my God, I gotta eat, right? So that's one of the first things I discovered that I was really saying, wow, I'm acknowledging that I'm stressed out and I don't really wanna eat that food right now. Now, most importantly, a lot of you watching right now say, well, that's not enough because if I want food, I'm gonna eat it. I'm with you. The next step is when you're hungry and you're stressed out, but you're saying, I'm not that stressed out, but I still wanna eat. We can replace the foods, the cookies. I mean, shoot, I used to fall asleep with a bag of Oreo cookies each and every night for almost 20 years. Well, from the ages of 7 and up, put it that way, till I was about 21. I always found, again, food was my best friend. So I would like you to attempt and replace the food, the naughty food that is in the kitchen or in the fridge, such as the Oreo cookies, the lasagna, whatever it is, certain foods that you know are not good for you, and replace them with foods such as fruits, such as veggies, such as yogurts, cottage cheese, almonds. And at least when you're getting those moments and those attacks, as I used to call them, that's what I used to tell my doctor, right? Like, doc, I got an attack coming down. What do I do? You know, everybody has different levels of depression, anxiety, and we could call it, again, stressful eating, emotional eating. Point is, we got issues, no one's perfect, and we take it out on something or someone, food being that. Let me tell you, ever since I changed my mind shift, acknowledging when I'm stressed out and doing an activity, me personally, I like to go working out, go for a jog, I meditate, all right? And second, when I'm hungry, I make sure I don't have shitty food inside my fridge, in my pantry, and those steps alone are amazing. Now, if you want more information, on how to like really kick ass and say, I want to transform my life. I have a program. It's called the 21 Day Kickoff. Now this program has nothing to do with going to the gym. It is a customizable food and fitness program for women and men that includes additionally a abs routine, a cardio routine, and it will legitimately get away with so many things that you're struggling with. It's like when I say get away, these little blocks that we have in our head sometimes are our own issues and our own stress, and our own mind wants to take over. I've had so many success stories of people that I've helped with my 21 day kickoff, and I hope you check it out. The link is going to be on the description. If you have any questions or comments or anything you want to add on, please leave a comment on the comments below. Show some love. If this inspired you, hey, hit a share. Have an amazing day, and most importantly, remember, it's all about mind right, body tight. Anything and everything you want in life, you can achieve and you will achieve. And I'm here to support you. Take it easy.